Tir opantukrator panagetri es alaisinimes, choisif not in tini gom shopinimen, gemon entan en ovo ethos, genenes lipsis, nemnen hokeg ivir erok, O Lord, make us worthy to pray thankfully our Father who art in heaven. I have sinned, forgive me. Shliel irini pasi.
Etub nevmatizu.
Maren shebeh motin tot fin beref erbethanef owo hena iit ifnoti ifyotin ben shoyis owo ben noti owo ben sotir isos bi e Christos. Je af eris kipanzini gon af ervoithineron af areh eron af shoptineruf af tiensu eron af titoten af intensha e ehri etai onothai enthof on marintihu eruf hoppos intif areh eron chen pai eh uus uab fai nemne eh otiron teben anch chen hirini niven en jebi pantokrator pshois pennuti O Master Lord God, the Pantocrator, the Father of our Lord God and Savior Jesus Christ, we thank you for everything, concerning everything and in everything, for you have covered us, helped us, guarded us, accepted us to yourself, spared us, supported us, and have brought us to this hour.
May have mercy and compassion on us, hear us, help us, and accept the supplication and prayers of his saints, for that which is good in our behalf at all times, and to keep the life of our sinning Father, the honored Patriarch Pope of Twedros II, and his pardon the liturgy, our Father, the Bishop of Youssef, and forgive us our
Lord, have mercy.
Therefore, we ask and entreat your goodness, O lover of mankind, grant us to complete this holy day and all the days of our life in all peace with your fear, all envy, all temptation, all the work of Satan, the counsel of wicked men, and the rising up of enemies hidden and manifest, take them away from us and from all your people, and from this church, and from this your holy place. But those things which are good and profitable, do provide for us, for it is you have given us the authority to tread on serpents and scorpions, and upon all the power of the enemy.
Artiro shere bi evangel
Elisi Sherebi Apostolos Abba Marcos Ore Moshir Ore Martinos Kisod Ben Kireye Emi Tishelet Veres Kosti Agia Emi Ve Rina Oni Et Cheno Efni Beniote Toa Bendias Kiti Sama Karaski Anaforitis In the best of only a phenomic me, even you to the web and battery. Ay, she saw Bakir and the small so beaming read. Then it's those tenty ho erok oyo steo. O Sethrek are one can be battery. Ay, she's Baba to address your sheriffs, Matagrof Hijan. Etronos nimbet kesh virili torogo os beniot toaben ike osaba Youssef devs kobos matagrof hijim bebe etronos hiten ebes veyan te tifeot kozidoe mariam shoysari emot bigo evolinten novi evren hasero Ot nimbek yotinna Agados nimbimdimma edu emce aton kalsoti emmon naynan
Şliiiiiiiiiiiiiiiiiiiiiiiiiiiiiiiiiiiiiiiiiiiiiiiiiiiiiiiiiiiiiiiiiiiiiiiiiiiiiiiiiiiiiiiiiiiiiiiiiiiiiiiiiiiiiiiiiiiiiiiiiiiiiiiiiiiiiiiiiiiiiiiiiiiiiiiiiiiiiiiiiiiiiiiiiiiiiiiiiiiiiiiiiiiiiiiiiiiiiiiiiiiiiiiiiiiiiiiiiiiiiiiiiiiiiiiiiiiiiiiiiiiiiiiiiiiiiiiiiiiiiiiiiiiiiiiiiiiiiiiiiiiiiiiiiiiiiiiiiiiiiiiiiiiiiiiiiiiiiiiiiiiiiiiiiiiiiiiiiiiiiiiiiiiiiiiiiiiiiiiiiiiiiiiiiiiiiiiii Again,
let us ask God upon the Creator, the Father of our Lord God and Savior, Jesus Christ. We ask and entreat your goodness, O lover of mankind. Remember, O Lord, the souls of your servants who have fallen asleep, our fathers and our brethren.
Pray for our fathers and brethren who have fallen asleep and repose in the faith of Christ since the beginning. Our fathers, our holy fathers, the archbishops, our fathers, the bishops, our fathers, the deacons, our fathers, the priests, and our brethren, the deacons, our fathers, the monks, and our fathers, the laymen, and for the full repose of the Christians, that Christ our God may repose all their souls in the paradise of joy, and we too accord mercy unto us and forgive us our sins.
Lord, have mercy.
Gracious Lord, repose all their souls in the bosom of our holy fathers, Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob. Sustain them in a green pasture beside still water in the paradise of joy, that place out of which grief, sorrow, groaning have fled away in the light of your saints. Raise up their bodies also in the day which I have appointed according to your true promises, which are without lie. Grant them the good things of your promises, that's which an eye has not seen nor ear heard, neither have come upon the heart of a man, the things which your God have prepared for them that will love your holy name. For there is no death for your servants, but a departure, even if in a negligence or heedlessness has overtaken them as men, since they were clothed in flesh and dwelt in this world. O God, as the good one lover of mankind, graciously accord, O Lord, your servants, the Orthodox Christians who are in the whole world, from the east to the west and from the north to the south, each one according to his name and each one according to her name, O Lord, repose and forgive them, for no one is pure and without a blemish, even though his life on earth be a single day. As for those, O Lord, whose souls you have taken, repose them, and may they be worthy of the kingdom of the heavens. As for us also, Lord, grant us our Christian perfection that would be pleasing to you, and give them on us a shared inheritance with all your saints.
Lord, have mercy.
Graciously accord, O Lord, to keep us tonight without sin. Blessed are you, Lord, God of our fathers, and it's blessed and glorified be your name forever. Amen. Let your mercy, O Lord, be upon us according to our hope in you. For the eyes of everyone wait upon you, for you give them their food in due season. Hear us, O God, our Savior, the hopeful audience of the earth, and you, O Lord, keep us safe from this generation forever. Amen. Blessed are you, O Lord, teach me your statutes. Blessed are you, O Lord, make me to understand your commandments. Blessed are you, O Lord, enlighten me through righteousness. Your mercy, O Lord, endures forever. Despise not, O Lord, the works of your hands. You have been my refuge from generation to generation. I asked the Lord and said, have mercy on me, heal my soul, for I have sinned against you. Lord, I have fled unto you, save me and teach me to do your will. For you are my God, and you are the fountain of life, and your light shall we see light. Let your mercy come unto those who know you, and your righteousness unto the upright in heart. To you belongs blessing, to you belongs praise, to you belongs glory. O Father, Son, the Holy Spirit, existing beginning, now and forever and ever. Amen. It is good to give thanks to the Lord and sing praise unto your name, O Most High, to show forth your mercy every morning and righteousness every morning. Holy God, holy mighty, holy mortal, who is born of the Virgin, have mercy on us. Holy God, holy mighty, holy mortal, who is crucified for us, have mercy on us. Holy God, holy mighty, holy immortal, who rose from the dead and ascends in heavens, have mercy on us. Glory be to the Father, and the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, and now and forever, and to ages of all ages. Amen. O Holy Trinity, have mercy on us. O Holy Trinity, have mercy on us. O Holy Trinity, have mercy on us. O Lord, forgive us our sins. O Lord, forgive us our iniquities. O Lord, forgive us our trespasses. O Lord, visit the sick of your people. Heal for the sake of your holy name. Our fathers and brethren have fallen asleep. O Lord, repose their souls. O hear that sin, Lord, have mercy on us. O hear that sin, Lord, have mercy for supplications. For there is the glory of the meaning of the triple holiness. Lord, have mercy. Lord, have mercy. Lord, bless. Amen. Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread. Forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil one. We pray to Jesus, our Lord, for thy kingdom, power, and glory forever.
Vespers Iesus ben Trisemin Alleluia Sherene Tentiho Ero Fief Owa If Mehen O Entoim Barthenos in Seoni Ven Timas Notif Mavim Bechristos
We ask you to remember us, O our faithful advocate, before our Lord Jesus Christ, that he may forgive us our sins.
Erem son selem mariam, chennif yawet saem shoysa owin amin bismin.
As David has said in the book of Psalms, the Queen stood at your right hand, O King.
Solomon moti eros chinbigo enteni gojitasoni awotaish bitabuli simmi Yerusalem.
For he has given a symbol of her in many high names, saying, come out of your garden, O choicest aroma.
Shirene oti marven ustira من الذين شرم شجن تل أرين بونان منوين.
We ask to remember us, O our faithful advocate, before our Lord Jesus Christ, that he may forgive us our sins.
O uni
of this world and the pride of this life, and you love the purity.
As shoshvim im satan, as nim nim vim o nim ho hi tin tisnish hi bo muni chen bin to bo in te tis parthenia.
For truly great is the chosen sanctity of Saint Verena the bride
of Christ.
Hail, O the virgin maiden, the holy adornment, the pure bride, the true Saint Verena.
Shirene uti agia, shirene uti eduab, shirene oskitis, shirene demni bemshor.
As the Lord on our behalf, O the bride of Christ, the true Saint Verena, that he may forgive us our sins.
Baba Abba Kirillus Vimaso, Ubi Macarius Chenom, if me be Taftagron Chen Benatin Orthodox and Taive me.
Your name is a pride, O pure monk, the strength in her mid, the fan of the anchorite.
And we buy a shobby and on an old tables, Chen and Sajin, Chen Tia, Rabbi, Chen Bishin, Moshi, Chen Bito, Chen if Nati.
Hail to you, loving Father, who healed the sick and foresaw miracles and cast out demons.
If it's Marot in Jebekvi, O so Pinot and Macari, O Sanctastunan, Bisoman of Amarcos, O Akir and Pimironeth, O.
Mary, the Mother of God, appeared miraculously with dozen and incense off of her treasures they too.
Akon Kathedra and Virin, Benishtin of Eaton of Amin, Anim Han Mishin, Ecclesia, Bekin, Mercy, and Aviemptir.
You rose at dawn, both in health and sickness, to praise with the angels and your beloved saints.
Tino Ari Pen Mevi, Narin, Ben Noti, Evrev Goknane, Volim Bekriti, Henti Arab, Henefnati.
Pray to the Lord on our behalf. Holy Father, the Patriarch of Akirillus, the sixth, and he may forgive us our sins.
Tuem Mshay Seriya, Gun Beniot, Thuaben Askiti, Savakaras, Benachori, Tistif, Novina, Nevon, Shobin Thoris, Omse, Gun Henimachosi, Tarakin Chetot, and Shusnitiren to the Otokos.
Ask of him whom you have born, our good Savior, to take away our troubles and grant us his peace.
Shirene oti barthenus tiroim min alidhine, shirem shoshun tebenginus arengvonan immanuin.
We ask you to remember us, O our faithful advocate, before our Lord Jesus Christ, that he may forgive us. We exalt you, the Mother of the True Light, who glorify you, O Saint, the Theotokos, for you are brought forth unto us the Savior of the whole world, came and saved our souls. Glory be to our Master, our King, Christ, the power of the Apostles, the crown of the martyrs, the joy of the righteous, the firmness of the churches, the goodness of sins. We proclaim the Holy Trinity, one Godhead, we worship him and glorify him. Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy, Lord, bless us, amen. We believe in one God, God, the Father, the Son of God, Lord, creator of heaven and earth, and of all things seen and unseen. We believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, begotten of the Father before all ages, light of light, true God, begotten, not created, of one essence of the Father, whom all things are made, who for us men and for our salvation came down from heaven, was incarnate of the Holy Spirit, of the Virgin Mary, and became man. And he was crucified for us under Pontius Pilate, suffered and was buried, and on the third day he rose from the dead. According to the scriptures, ascended to the heavens, he sits at the right hand of his Father, and he is coming again in his glory to judge the living and the dead, whose kingdom shall have no end. Yes, believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father, who the Father, the Son, is worshipped and glorified. Spoke by the prophets, one holy Catholic of the Slav Church,
we confess in baptism for remission of sins. Tengosh tevul chayet hinti ana.
See. Apuna.
Imon, semi galinome, sheret Jesus Christ.
Christ, our true God, who has come for our salvation, was incarnate.
Ave Cesarex Volchen Bemnev Mathoev Neme Volchen Maria Tishelethetho
and changed our sorrow and our troubles to joy for our hearts and total rejoicing.
Marinosem Mavoen Tenerem Nos and Tevem Avema Reyet Cherombi Ethnesos.
And let us all proclaim with the voice of joy, saying, Hail to you, Mary, the Mother of Emmanuel.
Sherene mare absot en adam beniot Sherene mare et mavdi maem vot Sherene mare et thelil en eva Sherene mare apono fenege nea.
Hail to you, Mary, the joy of evil, the just. Hail to you, Mary, the true virgin. Hail to you, Mary, the salvation of Noah. Hail to you, Mary, the chaste and undefiled.
Sherene mare abemoten Avram. Sherene mare abiklom en athlom. Sherene mare sot en sagve athoab. Sherene mare at maven fiat oab.
Hail to you, Mary, the rejoicing of Jacob. Hail to you, Mary, myriads of myriads. Hail to you, Mary, the bride of Judah. Hail to you, Mary, the mother of the Master.
Sherene mare abi oishem moisi Sherene mare at mavim despoti Sherene mare abtayon samoil Sherene mare ab shosham besarail.
Hail to you, Mary, that's as fast as of Job the just. Hail to you, Mary, the precious stone. Hail to you, Mary, the mother of the beloved. Hail to you, Mary, the daughter of King David.
Sherene mare ejvirin Solomon. Sherene mare ejvshisin zike on. Sherene mare ebogayen saeyes. Sherene mare talechoni eremeyes.
Hail to you, Mary, the knowledge of Ezekiel. Hail to you, Mary, the grace of Daniel. Hail to you, Mary, the power of Elijah. Hail to you, Mary, the grace of Elisha.
Sherene mare ative otokos. Sherene mare Mavenisos Betherescon, Sherene mare Techerombi, Evneson, Sherene mare Mavenios Theos.
Hail to you, Mary, who was witnessed by all the prophets, and they said, Behold, God, the Word was incarnate of you in an indescribable unity.
In Shosi Alithos, Ehonti Beshvot, In Te Aron Odeyat, Menemot, Ashbebi Eshvot, Evile Mare, Ashe Entom Bepti Bos, تزمر ثنيا
She conceived and gave birth with our amen to the Son of the Highest The Word Himself through her interiors And intercessions, O Lord, open unto us the gates of the church.
Tati hoeroti theotokos kabro enie keglisia voine nibestos marenti hoeros Εδρεστο βεγον άρεν βεσμενερι εδρευγον ανεβον.
You are called, O Virgin Mary, the holy flower of incense.
Ιεταστι ο εμσοι ασβήρι εβον χενεθνον ενι πατρεία
Like the rod of Aaron the priest, which blossomed and brought forth
fruit.
Wherefore we glorify you as the Mother of God, ask your Son to forgive us.
Amin b'oron tetihirin moinanen tekhirin nanen tekhirin karnovi nane volgore
voleni gajin tetihik ekliseyari Softeros enneskem chaine
Emmanuel bennoti chenten mititin Uchen poen tebeviot nembeb nevmaduab
Entefes moeron tiren entef tovo ennen hit Entef talcho nishon enten erepsikinem Nen somaten
oshtem moko becherestos Nen bekyoten avathos Nen bebnev matoam sheakton katsot
I open my mouth with praise and glorify the name of Jesus. I praise the martyr of Christ, Rev Mercurius. He wore the shield and helmet. He was strengthened by the Holy One. Full of strength and goodness be it, Rev Mercurius.
Kalladu malak Allah bisif yabrak le mi'akad ثبته في يدي مثل البرق الساطع مال حكمة ورحمة وأعطى غلبة ونصرة وأيضا قوة جمة حتى كسر الأعداء
He marched before the soldiers with the sign of Pistaros to fight the barbarians with O.F. Mercurius He rode on his horse with courage He attacked them whenever they retreated He blocked them
رأوا بربر بسيف والبرق ساطع فيهم فوق رأسه مرفوعين يضرب بهما فيهم قابض عالسيف واستلوا وصرخ صرختهم لما نظروا ولوا وصاروا في قناهم
Faint-hearted and in weakness, they quickly disbanded to their land. They escaped, the ranks were scattered, famed among the barbarians, known as of the two swords. They bowed to him humbly, even if he stands alone.
شَعْزِكْرُ عِنْدِ النَّسْ مِنْ كُلِّ بِلَدْ وَجْنَسْ بِالْقُوَّةِ وشدة البأس محب الإب مركوريوس استيقظ من الدنيا وطلب السمائية ورفض كل المقتنيات أموالا وعقارات.
He thanked God for His grace, went forth to deceive us. He cast down His sword, confessing the holy name. The King was angry, Decius the infidel. He shouted to the soldiers to torture Mercurius.
رموا وسط الحضرة وضربوا ضربا بكسرة والعذابات مر بين الأمراء والوزراء عند المساء سحبوا إلى السجن محبوس وقت الصباح وجدوا وجسدوا سالم محروس.
Unbelievers were ashamed. Decius was humiliated. They all took counsel in order to destroy him. The judge his case that he be beheaded. On the 25th of Athor, he received the righteous crown.
لبسك للغير مضمحل انت تيمت مرتيروس والملائكة تهلل أكسيوس 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 تفسير اسمك في أفواه كل المؤمنين الكل يقولون يا إله كريوس أعين
In the triumphant church with the faithful shepherd amongst all the saints be Athoab Abbas Chayron in the place of peace with great veneration after much suffering be Athoab Abbas Chayron
في مسكن التالي أعطاك الله إكليل ليس له مثيل بسواب أبس خريون ولدت في كل تذكر اسمك سامين في قلوبنا كل حين بسواب أبس خريون.
In the days of Diocletian you witnessed to the Holy One through your faith in Athoab Abbas Chayron, you would not worship idols which Satan dwells in. You would not deny the faith, Athoab Abbas Chayron.
بكلامك النافس انتصرت على إبليس طوباك يا قديس بثواب أبس خيرون. قوي في ثباتك عظيم في شجاعتك اذكر نفط الباطك
بثواب أبس خيرون. You prayed to your God and He sent you an angel who supported and strengthened you بثواب أبس خيرون. Your promise riches by your faith wasn't shaken
إن حلت القيود في السفينة أمام الجنود فكانوا هم شهود احتملت شد الألم طرحوا في نار الحمام أمضيت ستة أيام
You are praising God who was glorified in His might. He delivered you from the rule. Bethoab Chayron, you are great in your works. Even in through your suffering, God has rewarded you. Bethoab Chayron.
أحضروا لك ساحر في ده ماهر أعطاك ثم النادر
بثواب أبس خيرون
صليت ورشمت الصليب واتكلت على الحبيب وشربت بثبات عجيب
بثواب أبس خيرون Confess before the pagan ruler, receive the splendid crown Bethoab Abbas. On the seventh of Bauna, the church joyfully gathers to celebrate her martyrdom Bethoab
بس خيرا
فكان استقبيك اللي كان الناس مجتمعين بسر زجا فرحين طلبوك بإسرار وقت هجوم الأشرار نجتهم من الأخطار
The church to the village of me, and they all greatly rejoice me at the web of us. This is one of the miracles that reveals the great one. Remember us in your prayers, be Elohab Abbas Khairon.
Utlum min aglina ya shafi'na kullana mis sharrina gina misuwab
Abbas Khairon.
Tafsir ismak fi afwa kullil mu'minin al kull ya kulun ya ina
بس خيرون عنا أجمعين خير
رقدوا يا رب نيحهم إخواتنا الذين في كل شدة يا رب عنا وإياهم
May God bless us and let us bless His holy name and may His praise be always on our lips Jebus Marod and Jeb Yot Nemeshi
Irene Pasi
O Master Lord Jesus Christ our God,
Blessed to his saintly honored disciples and holy apostles. Many prophets and righteous men have desired to see the things which you see and have not seen them, and to hear the things which you hear and have not heard them. But bless your eyes for they see, and your ears for they hear. May we be worthy to hear and to act according to your holy gospels, through the prayers of your saints.
Pray for the Holy Gospel.
Lord, have mercy.
Remember also our Master, all those who have been in us, remember them in our supplication and prayers, which we offer upon to you, O Lord, our God. Those who have already fallen asleep, repose them. Those who are sick, heal them. For you are the life of us all, the salvation of us all, the hope of us all, the healing of us all, and the resurrection of us all.
Salmus tu davin gollilu yatina onna ke volem shoiz banuti khin bahinti irfuo intatium bekran shayini جاء انثق اونشتي او فيرين هانش فيري انثق اما بان كيف نوتي اثنا فالليلويا ما رود شاس خليتك ليسيا انت بفلاوس او ما رو اسمو ارفيت كاتدران تانيا برزفيت روز جاف قنوم تيود امبريت انهانسو ايبن افن جنيت سوتونو ابيونوف ابون كنجم شويسون نفو من نثيم جنثوك بافو ومشايني قطع التاكسيس ملشي سادك Choice saw in am mukbin yothu am batrayar shis baba ava tawadros bimahes nav nim bin yothin ebiskobus ava yoseb Choice ave are beten on khalilu ya
Fizmara utin jefi esneyo khenefran ime pshoiz enteni gom kirie eflogi sonik tukata methe on ageyu ef angeliu tu anagnusma
sasi kereya
Open Nuti, open Sotir, open Urutirin, Isos be Christos, Epshir, Emfnot, et Onch, Pioon of Shaini. And when they had come to the multitude, a man came to him, kneeling down to him and saying, Lord, have mercy on my son, for he is an epileptic and suffers severely. For he often falls into the fire and often into the water. So I brought him to your disciples, but they could not cure him. Then Jesus answered and said, O faithless and perverse generation, how long shall I be with you? How long shall I bear with you? Bring him here to me. And Jesus rebuked the demon, and he came out of him. And the child was cured from that very hour. Then the disciples came to Jesus privately and said, Why could we not cast him out? So Jesus said to them, Because of your unbelief, for assuredly I say to you, if you have faith as a mustard seed, you will say to this mountain, move from here to there, and it will move, and nothing will be impossible for you. However, this kind does not go out except by prayer and fasting.
Be to God forever. Marin o ushtim ben sotir bi mayro min agath ushen togavshin onaf I oaf sotim moner brezvavinet Gono te chosin epteren te veoto kosmare yaf mavim ben sotir tifkanin nov Nebol dovehem em shoy sereye gono ti shelet te berestus ti agiyya emmi verin Kanin novina nebol jefiz marotin jefiot nemim shirin embem nev maith oev te triya sejikev ten oshtem mosten ti ones
Our God, King of all ages, who has granted us this amazing gift full of glory, which are the relics of Saint Philobatir Mercurius, Saint Abbas Khairon el-Ellini, Saint Christozoulos, and Saint Bistavros the New Martyr, who had strived well for your name's sake, expelled all the power of the enemy, and carried their holy cross for the sake of the heavenly dwellings of life. And now their holy relics are venerated on earth in this honored church where we worship you. You have also granted them healing springs to cure all sickness in the people and expel evil spirits. Now, O good Master, lover of mankind, we ask and entreat you through the sufferings of these holy martyrs, which they accepted for your blessed name, to give us health through their holy relics, and to grant us, O our Savior, and to all those who worship you, salvation, forgiveness of sins, healing to our souls, bodies, and spirits, and to give them and us a good portion and salvation, that we may glorify you, O Christ our God, with your good Father, and the Holy Spirit, the life giver, who is one essence with you now and forever, on the age of the ages. Amen. Shleel. Irini pasi
Tom neumatiso.
Again, let us ask God the Pantocrator, the Father of our Lord God and Savior Jesus Christ. We ask and entreat your goodness, O lover of mankind. Remember, O Lord, the peace of your one only holy Catholic and Apostolic Church.
Pray for the peace of the one holy Catholic and Apostolic Orthodox Church of God.
Lord, have mercy.
This which exists from one end of the world to the other, remember, O Lord, our honored patriarch and father, the archpriest Pope Avatawadu II, and his spiritual brethren, the patriarch of Antioch Maragnatz Afram II, and the patriarch of Eritrea Abuna Antonius, and his partner in the apostolic liturgy, our father, the bishop of Youssef.
Pray for our Archpriest Pope Avatawadris II, Pope and Patriarch and Archbishop of the great city of Alexandria, and his spiritual brethren in the Apostolic Liturgy, the Patriarch of Antioch Marignatius Ephraim II, and the Patriarch of Eritrea Abun Antonius, and his partner in the Liturgy, our Father the Bishop of Youssef, and for our Orthodox Bishops.
Lord have mercy.
Keep them secure for us for many years and peaceful times. Remember, O Lord, the salvation of this holy place and every monastery of our Orthodox fathers.
Pray for the salvation of the world and of the city of ours and of all cities, districts, islands, and monasteries.
Lord, have mercy.
And every city and every country and all the villages and all their adornments, and save all of us from all famine, plagues, earthquakes, drowning, fire, captivity by the barbarians, and the sword of the stranger, and the rising up of the heretics. Lord, have mercy. graciously, O Lord, remember, O Lord, the seeds, the herbs, the plants of the field this year.
Pray for the seeds, herbs, and the plants of the field this year, that Christ our God may bless them to grow and multiply with unto perfection with great fruit. Have compassion on his creation, which his hands have made, and forgive us our sins.
Lord, have mercy. Lord, have mercy. Lord, have mercy.
Raise them to their measure according to your grace. Give joy to the face of the earth. May its furrows be abundantly watered and its fruits be plentiful. Prepare it for sowing and harvesting. Manage our life as deemed fit. Bless the crown of the year with your goodness for the sake of the poor of your people, the widow, the orphan, the traveler, the stranger, and for the sake of us all who entreat you and seek your holy name. For the eyes of everyone wait upon you, for you give them their food in due season. Deal with us according to your goodness, O you who give food to all flesh. Fill our hearts with joy and gladness, that we too, having sufficiency in everything always, may abound in every good deed.
Lord, have mercy.
As God the Father of our Lord God and Savior Jesus Christ, we ask and entreat your goodness, O lover of mankind, to remember, O Lord, our assemblies. Bless them.
Pray for this holy church and for our assemblies.
Lord, have mercy.
Grant that they may be to us without obstacle or hindrance, that we may hold them according to your holy and blessed will, houses of prayer, houses of purity, houses of blessings. Grant them to us, O Lord, and to your servants who will come after us forever. Arise, O Lord the God, let all your enemies be scattered, and let all who hate your holy name flee before your face. But let your people be in blessing, thousand of thousand, and 10,000 times 10,000, doing your will, our Father who art in heaven.
Hallowed be thy name, thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread. Forgive us our trespasses as we forgive those who trespass against us. Lead us not into temptation.
O Master Lord Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son and Logos of God the Father, who has broken every bond of our sins through his life-giving sufferings, who breathed in the face of his holy disciples and saintly apostles and said to them, receive the Holy Spirit. If you forgive the sins of any, they are forgiven. If you retain the sins of any, they are retained. You also now, our Master, through your holy apostles, have given grace to those who for a time labor in the priesthood in your holy church to forgive sins upon the earth and to bind and to loose the bond of iniquities. We ask and entreat your goodness, O lover of mankind, for your servant, those who bow their heads before your holy glory, dispense unto us your mercy. Loose every bond of our iniquities. If we have committed any sin against you, no longer unknown, through anguish of heart, or in deed, or in word, or from faint-heartedness, O Master, who knows the weakness of men, as a good one and lover of mankind, O God, grant us the forgiveness of our sins. Bless us, absolve us, and all your people. Fill us with your fear, straighten us unto your goodwill, for you are our God, and glory, honor, dominion, and worship are due to you, together with your good Father, Holy Spirit, now and forever, on the edge of the ages. Amen.
Amen. Kyrie eleison, Kyrie eleison, Kyrie eleison.
Faddal istariah.
Okay, kids only, from VPK and up to second graders, you need to go to St. Maurice Hall to get ready for the St. Mark Festival trophies. All kids, quietly, We are in the church. No running. VPK, KG, first and second only. No parents. Everybody else, sit down.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, one God, Amen. Our Bible study tonight from the Gospel of St. John, chapter 10, starting from verse 22. Now, it was the feast of dedication in Jerusalem, and it was winter. This section is a further discussion with the unbelieving Jews occurred at the Feast of Dedication. And this was done in the winter time. The Feast of Dedication is also known as the Feast of Lights, Eid al-Anwar. That's called Hanukkah. And was instituted by Judas Maccabeus. You can read about this feast in the two books of Maccabees, in the canonical books that omitted by the Protestant, first and second Maccabees. In commemoration of his purifying the temple after it had been defiled by Antiochus Epiphanius, and then rededicated the temple to the service of God. That's why this feast is called the Feast of Dedication. Verse 23, and Jesus walked in the temple in Solomon's porch. Jesus was walking in a porch of the temple called Solomon's porch. This was not part of the actual temple itself, but it was a large covered area in the temple grounds. And later, the early church often used this part for meeting and teaching, as we read in Acts chapter 3, verse 11, and in Acts chapter 5, verse 12. And this demonstrates that this porch was large enough area to accommodate very large crowd, where everyone could yet hear the one who is speaking. So although it's a large area, but anybody preaches or speaks, everybody can hear him. Verse 24. Then the Jews surrounded him and said to him, how long do you keep us in doubt? If you are the Christ, tell us plainly. Actually, the Lord Jesus Christ, several times, he said it in plain terms that he is the Messiah. Like in John chapter 4, he said it to the Samaritan woman. But also frequently, he delivered this truth so openly to them that he came from heaven. He is the Messiah. That he is the one sent by the Father to the world, that all men should be saved by believing in him. He made it plainly that he is the Son of God and one with the Father. But their perception was distorted. In response to this, they accused him of blasphemy because they told him, you, while you are human being, you made yourself a God. So now they are telling him, why you put ourselves in doubt? If you are Christ, tell us plainly. He said it several times. So why now they wanted again, asked him again to declare it that he is a Messiah, that they may accuse him of rebel and traitor to the Romans authorities, and to accuse him as a blasphemer in order to find accusation to kill him and to get rid of him. So they desire to appear as individuals who are seeking knowledge, but the real intention, they want to accuse him with something that they may present him to the Romans authorities to kill him and to get rid of him. Other commentators find this question was a true reflection of their inner conflict. Sometimes they know from his work that he is a Messiah, but the Pharisees and the religious teachers tell them he is not. So there was inner conflict inside their heart. They sensed his holiness, perceived through his deeds, and they recognized his stature. But they feared for their position, because the religious leaders threatened if anyone confessed that he is the Christ, he will be kicked out of the temple. Like the parents of the man who was born blind in chapter 9, they refused to confess that he is Christ because they feared for their position, their corrupt souls preventing them from accepting him as the Savior. Verse 25, Jesus answered them, I told you, and you do not believe. So I told you plainly before, but you do not believe. The works that I do in my Father's name, they bear witness of me. So here, as in John chapter 8, verse 25, where was a similar question to Christ, similar direct question, but the Lord answered in John 8 and in here in John 10 indirectly. It couldn't be otherwise, because their misconception of the messianic work had made the very word Messiah an impossible one for him to utter to them. To tell him, I am the Messiah, actually, it was impossible for him to say it to them, because in their mind, the Messiah should be a temporal king, a temporal king who will restore to them the earthly kingdom of David. And if Jesus said that he is the Messiah according to their understanding, that he is an earthly king, came to restore the kingdom to David, then he is contradicting the essential truth, which is he is a heavenly king, came to establish the kingdom of God on earth. That's why he refused to answer them plainly. But he referred them to his earlier words, I told you before, and to his deeds in proof of what he is. He is the true Son of God. But to those who have simple heart and inquired to know the truth, like the Samaritan woman, like the man who was born blind, the Lord used plain words, saying directly, I am the Messiah, as he said to the Samaritan woman, and as he said to the man who was born blind. But to these unbelieving Jews, again and again, he told them the same truth, but indirectly by referring them to his deeds and to the witness of others about him. because the actual truth never crossed into their hearts. When he told them, I am the Messiah, I am one with the Father, they took stone to stone him and to put him to death. So he told them, I am the light of the world. I am the Son of God. I am the Good Shepherd. I have come to save the world. I have come to give life to the world. I have come to give liberty to the world. I have come to redeem everybody. All these words actually is a proof that he is the Messiah without using the word the Messiah, because for them Messiah is an earthly king. Also, he told them he must die and rise again. He is the absolute master of his life and of his death. Nobody has authority over his life and over his death, but he has authority over his life. He will lay down his soul by himself and he will take it up again. No human being can claim this except God. So as if he was telling them, have you not noticed my all knowledge in searching and discovering the very secrets of heart? So I have omniscience. Have you not seen my omnipotence, the power, all powerful, in the miracles which I wrote? Have not all these been sufficient to convince you? But unfortunately, yet you do not believe until now. That's why in verse 26 he told them, but you do not believe because you are not of my sheep, as I said to you. Now, by refusing to believe in him and to follow his doctrine, by their own willful blindness, they choose to be blind, then they are not of his sheep, as he told them. All these things can tell you that I am the Messiah, but you turn it a blind eye to my works, to my deeds, to my knowledge, to the witness of the Father, to the witness of the prophets, to the witness of John the Baptist. You turn it blind eye because you are not of my sheep. Verse 27, my sheep hear my voice and I know them and they follow me. So Christ here is saying that his sheep hear his voice and follow him. So let us ask ourselves as an application, do we cling closely to this heavenly shepherd? Do we follow him by our faith and our lives? Do we know him and hear his voice, or just hear about him? Do we fly from strangers? Do we flee from strangers, from the world, from the lust of the flesh, and from the devil? If so, then we are his sheep indeed. If we persevere, he will bring us, in spite of the world, the flesh, and the devil, to the pastures of eternal life. As he said in verse 28, and I will give them eternal life, and they shall never perish, neither shall anyone snatch them out of my hand. So for those who hear his voice, those who follow him in his footsteps, then in spite of all the temptation around us, the world, the flesh, the devil, he will take us into the pasture of eternal life. But if we run away from our shepherd to follow strangers, then we must expect to fall a prey or a victim to the wolf. That's why he said, they will never perish. So here actually the word perish indicate fearsome eternal destruction. He's speaking about the eternal destruction and the eternal damnation. And when he said, neither shall anyone snatch them out of my hand. The word snatch indicates violent action using against a person. So no one can protect us from such violence except the powerful hand of God that hold and shield us. If we are in his hand, nobody can snatch us from his hand, because the Lord Jesus Christ provide protection for those who believe in him, are faithful to him, and follow him. Notice that the Lord Jesus Christ said, I give them eternal life in the present tense, not in the future. He did not say, I will give them. He said, I give them eternal life. Because we start the eternal life here on earth when we follow the Lord Jesus Christ. The kingdom of God is in your heart. So this gift is present and continuous to eternity. Verse 29, my Father who has given them to me, has given this sheep to me, is greater than all, and no one is able to snatch them out of my Father's hand. God the Father is more powerful than all the united energies of men and demons. If we put all the energy and the power of men and demons together, God is powerful than all these united energies. So we are protected by the Holy Trinity, by God the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. He who loves God must be happy, and he who fears God and walk in the fear of God should not fear anything else. He is in the protection of the Holy Trinity. The Lord Jesus Christ say again, no one is able to snatch them out of my Father's hand. So in this manner, he indicated that his hand and the hand of the Father are one, similar in the terms of power, and in essence, for they are the same. Nobody can snatch us from the hand of the Son, and nobody can snatch us from the hand of the Father. Meaning that the hand of the Father in its power is similar to the hand of the Son in its power, because Father and the Son are one in essence. That's why in verse 30 he said, I and my Father are one. I and my Father are one. He did not say, I and my Father are identical, but I and my Father are one, to emphasize their unity, their oneness. They are one in essence. Yes, they are distinguished, but they are one. So this indicates a union of love and work, as well as union in essence. Jesus is claiming unity with God in a way other people do not have. Nobody, no human being can say, I and the Father are one. Nobody can say this. So he is claiming deity. He is claiming that he is God. He is God indeed. And the unity of the Most Holy Trinity cannot be divided. Yes, they are distinguished into three divine persons, but they are one. When he said, I and my Father, means the Holy Trinity, the creator of all things, the judge of all men, the Father of the Spirit, here we speak about the Father of the Spirit, of all flesh are one. So Jesus with the Father who is the creator of all things, the judge of all men, the Father of the Spirit of all flesh are one. One in essence, one in all the attributes of Godhead, one in all the operations of these attributes. So it is very evident that the Jews understood that he is speaking about his divinity. That's why in verse 31, then the Jews took up stones again to stone him. So now plainly he said to them, I am God, I am the Messiah. In the beginning told him, if you are the Messiah, tell us, why you keep us in doubt? He told them, and what's the reaction? They took stones to kill him. St. Augustine said, listen to the Son himself. I and the Father are one. He did not say, I am the Father, or I and the Father are one person. But when he says, I and the Father are one, notice the two words, we are and one. I and the Father, we. So we are one. For if they are one, then they are not diverse. And if we are, then there is both a Father and the Son. So St. Augustine is emphasizing the Trinity. Father is different than the Son, is different than the Holy Spirit. They are distinguished, three different persons, but these three different persons are one in essence. Because sometimes some of us believe that the Father is the Son, is the Holy Spirit. This is the heresy of Sabellius, and the church excommunicated him, because the Father is not the Son, is not the Holy Spirit, but the three persons are one, one in essence. St. Augustine continues and says, the Jews understood well enough what the Arians, the followers of Arius, did not understand. The Jews understood from the word of Christ that he is divine. That's why they took stones to kill him. But Arius and his followers, they could not understand this verse that Jesus is true God and he is divine. And he is one in essence with the eternal Father. So the Jews, in opposition to our Savior's doctrine, took up stones to kill him in order that he might preach no more to them that he is divine. How? You make yourself God. That's blasphemy. You are a human being. And the word took up stone again. The word again, because they had attempted to do this before, as we read in John chapter 8, verse 59. So this was not the first time they wanted to stone him. But it seems they were prevented from doing this now, either by divine power prevented them from stoning him, because as we read in verses 32, the Lord Jesus responded and talked to them. Verse 32, Jesus answered them, many good works I have shown you from my Father. For which of those works do you stone me? When he said, from my Father, again, to emphasize that he is divine, he and the Father are one. So, he responded by calling attention again to his works, to his miracle. He had done many. Obviously, the power had come to him because he is one with the Father. So he asked, which one of them was their justification for stoning him? So, verse 33, the Jews answered him saying, for a good work, we do not stone you, but for blasphemy. And because you, being a man, make yourself God. Definitely, if Jesus is a man and we are making him God, then we are blasphemers. Jesus is not a man who made himself God, but Jesus is God who became man. Big difference between this and that. So, definitely the Lord Jesus Christ, he knew they were not stoning him for the miracles. But his intent by this question, for which work you are stoning me, to point out that in determining to stone him, they were again overlooking his miracles that proves his divinity. If you look at my miracles, you would know that I am divine, because nobody can do such miracles. No matter how many miracles he did proving that he is God, they were determined to find fault with him. They ignored the evidence and attacked anything that seemed to imply that he was from God. But if the evidence was valid, then he was from God, and there was no ground to attack him. They ought instead to have accepted that he is God and followed him. The evidence is so clear, but they turned a blind eye. That's why he called attention, their attention again, to his miracle, and asked them, which of them was grounds of killing me? And he said, these miracles are from the Father. So he intended to confirm that he and the Father work together. He and the Father are one. They responded that it was not his good works that led them to seek to kill him, but the fact he claimed to be God, though he was a man. But not again that the Jews here recognized Jesus' statement as a claim to divinity, that he is divine. When he told them, I and the Father are one, they understood it, that he is claiming divinity, which Arius and his followers could not understand. And what irritated them so much that they understood him as speaking of unity in essence with the Father. Therefore, they said here to him, you make yourself God, which they understood, not in a figurative way, not in a metaphorical way, not in improper sense, but in most literal meaning of the term, that he is God. And here he sees the contradictions. He told him, if you are the Messiah, tell us. And when he told them, they took stone to stone him. Then the Lord Jesus Christ, in verse 34, he replied, Jesus answered them, is it not written in your law, I said you are gods? The word the law here referring to the Old Testament in general. Sometimes the word the law refer to the five books of Moses or to the Old Testament in general. So this verse is in the book of Psalms, not in the five books of Moses. Psalm 82, verse 6, in which men were called gods, gods with a small g. In this passage, the psalmist was speaking to the judge of Israel and calling them gods with a small g. Why they were called gods? Because they were representative of God, acting in God's place for people, to judge the people. So they are spoken of as gods because they are acting in the place of God, judging people. And the word here does not, of course, mean they are divine. No, they are representative of God. That's why we say small g, not capital G. That's why the psalmist continues and says, but you shall die like men and fall like one of the princes. So I called you gods because you are representative of God, but you are not divine. You shall die like men and fall like one of the princes. Psalm 82. So the Lord Jesus Christ appealed to this passage in the book of Psalms, in their Old Testament, which they themselves accepted as authority. They accept the book of Psalms as a canonical book. Then he argued in verse 36, do you say of him whom the Father sanctified? Sanctified means consecrated for a certain mission, which is salvation of the world, and sent into the world. You are telling him you are blaspheming because I said I am the Son of God. So the argument here, if the scripture spoke about the judges of Israel, who are human beings, as gods, how could you object if I say I am the Son of God and I have the evidence that God the Father has sent me to the world in the transfiguration and in the baptism? God the Father said, this is my beloved Son in whom I am well pleased. The prophecies testified about me. The John the Baptist testified about me. My works testified about me. My words testified about me. How can you deny all this evidence and say to me I am blaspheming when I tell you the absolute truth that I am the Son of God? Verse 35. Again, I will go back to 35. If he called them gods to whom the word of God came, and the scripture cannot be broken. So the Lord is saying, if he called them gods to whom the word of God came and entrusted them to be judges of Israel, just because the word of God came to them, they are gods and the scripture cannot be broken. For me, the word of God did not come to me because I am the word of God. I am the word of God myself. So, if the scripture so spoke, how could you object? And the scripture cannot be broken. Jesus is affirming, as he has in past reference to sacred scripture, the scripture consists of very words of God. The scripture are the breath of God, word of God. And its teaching is true because God himself, he spoke this word. And the scripture is reliable testimony which cannot be ignored or set aside. So, whether he is a blasphemer or not depends upon whether he represents God or not, or to prove his appeals again to works. Then if there is evidence that he is the word of God, he is the Son of God, then he is not a blasphemer. So, he is asking him, are my works the work of the Father or not? If my works are the work of the Father, then I'm not blaspheming. But if my works are not the work of the Father, then I am blaspheming. If the people had trouble believing my claim, you need actually to accept the conclusion by my works and by the testimony of the prophets, the Father, and John the Baptist. So, if they looked at all this evidence, then he is truly from God. He is the Son of God. There was no other explanation for his miracles. No other explanation. Then they surely had no ground, therefore, to kill him. For his very miracles proved God was working these miracles through him. The work of Jesus are enough to manifest and indicate and declare to the people that his mission in the eyes of the people, that he is God, the Son of God who is sent to the world to save the people. And to support, his works are support to his claim of divinity. He has shown absolute power over creation, and that he can suspend the law of nature. God has power over death, Jesus power over death, over illness, over nature, and over demons. No human being has power over these things. Nature, death, illness, and demons. So his works give testimony to his true nature. Then to kill him means they are against God the Father. And he expressed his relationship with God by saying the Father was within him and he is in Father. When he said, I am in the Father and the Father is in me. And all these words implies divinity, though not so directly as in verse 30 when he said, I and the Father are one. So, in verse 37 he said, if I don't do the works of my Father, do not believe me. Examine my work. If my work are not the work of the Father, don't believe me. But as I shown you, I have authority over nature. I can suspend the law of nature, illness, death, and demons. These are the works of the Father. But if I do the works of the Father, though you do not believe me, believe the works, that you may know and believe that the Father is in me and I in him. And again, he made it very clearly. I am in the Father and the Father is in me. I am in the Father and the Father is in me, because I am the Father and one. The Jews could not reply his argument. That's why they took a stone to kill him. As we read in verse 39, therefore they sought again to seize him, but he escaped out of their hand. When they cannot answer or reply to his argument, that's where the violence is. Like terrorists, when they cannot reply to any evidence, they start to kill the Christian. The same attitude here. They couldn't reply to his argument except by stones. The evidence of the truth could not be resisted. That's why they wanted to destroy him who said the truth. But he escaped out of their hand. The Bible or St. John did not explain to us how he escaped their hand. So maybe he just walked and ran away from among them. While they were plotting how to arrest him, he just passed out of the temple. The same verse exactly, we read it in John 8:59. They wanted to stone him and he escaped out of their hand. Or maybe in a miraculous way, he made himself invisible, or he hindered them by a divine power from arresting him. Verse 40, and he went away again beyond the Jordan to the place where John was baptizing at first, and there he stayed. Perhaps the Lord Jesus Christ realized that he had now pushed the conflict as far as it could go without killing him. But his time to die had not yet come for that. That's why he went for a time east of the Jordan, beyond the Jordan, in the east side of the Jordan, to the place where some time earlier John had been baptizing. So he went to the place where John was baptizing. Because there, in the east of Jordan, beyond the Jordan, the people were more receptive. So he had one final period of safety before returning back to Jerusalem for the final confrontation that led to his death and his crucifixion. Verse 41, then many came to him and said, John performed no sign, But all things that John spoke about this man were true. Many of us, when we hear about a saint, we ask, what are his miracles? We connect saints with miracles. But here in verse 41, John the Baptist performed no sign. He performed no miracle. So miracles are not evidence of sainthood. The Lord said in Matthew chapter 7, many people will say to him, in your name we cast out demons, in your name we heal the sick. But he will tell them, depart from me, evildoers. I do not know you. What is evidence of sainthood is bearing the fruit of the Spirit, not doing miracles. And I hope this will be clear in our mind. Many people who are performing miracles, even casting out demons, the Lord will tell them, I do not know you. John the Baptist, the greatest among those who born of women, performed no miracles. But he is the greatest among those born of women. There is no relationship between miracles and sainthood. I hope this will be clear in your mind. John the Baptist's work of preparing the people for the Messiah, until now, even after his martyrdom, is producing results. The people refer to the word of John the Baptist. The crowd who accepted his message are now following Jesus Christ. They believed the testimony of John the Baptist about Jesus Christ, that Jesus is the Messiah, the Son of God, as he said in John chapter 1, verse 34. So they concluded that what John had said about Jesus is true, and they believed in the Lord Jesus Christ. And again, note that John the Baptist did no miracles. None were ever recorded, and here we are told directly that he did not do any miracle. But the people accepted John the Baptist as a prophet because of his life, because he bore the fruit of the Spirit in his life. That's why verse 42, and many believed in him, in Jesus there, because of the testimony of John the Baptist, whom they knew to be a good and a wise man and a prophet of the Lord, and they knew he could neither deceive nor be deceived about the Messiah. That's why they trusted him, trusted John the Baptist. And the testimony of John the Baptist, beside the miracle of Jesus Christ, this made them believe that Jesus is the Messiah, is Son of God. They fully proved that all that John had said of this man, Jesus, was true. But the scribe and Pharisees, with all their science and their knowledge, could not draw a conclusion so just like these simple people beyond the Jordan. This concludes actually chapter 10 from the Gospel of St. John. Glory be to God forever and ever. Amen.